The Irish President Mary McAleese has said this week's first visit by the Queen to Ireland demonstrates the success of the Northern Ireland peace process. Police in the Australian city of Brisbane say a man who fell to his death from a seventh-floor balcony was taking part in the internet craze of planking. The practice involves someone lying flat on their stomach in an unusual or dangerous situation and then putting a photograph of it on social networking websites.
PCC will today launch a text number people can use to report cases of suspected child abuse.
The charity believes it will help the public become the eyes and ears of social workers. Well, Linda Papadopoulos is a psychologist and the NSPCC's ambassador for the helpline. Very good morning to you. People who suspect that a child might be in trouble can already phone the police, they can already phone social services, they can already phone the NSPCC. What's different?
I think a couple of things. First of all, this is a text service, so it allows you to act immediately. And I think a lot of times the research that we've done shows that when people don't act immediately, they talk themselves out of it. So it's anonymous, it's a text service, and it's national, which means you don't have to sit there and think, who do I call? Is it the police? Is it social services? You know, how much information do I have to give? Do I actually have to speak to someone? So what it does is it hopefully removes a lot of those barriers that stop people from acting right away.
But some people might argue, for exactly the same reasons, that a little bit of thought about something you've seen is not a bad thing. I mean, the idea of immediately sort of texting something you've seen without, I don't know, checking the circumstances or whatever, I mean, that's a worry in itself, isn't it? And is there a danger as well that given this sort of anonymity you have with the text, that people would use it just maliciously and almost, you know, teenagers just do something... text a number?
Sure. I mean, this is a fear with anything you do. I mean, I was speaking to someone at the RSPCA and they said, actually, what tends to happen is that these bogus calls are filtered through quite quickly. I think the people at the end of the line are very, very clear about what indicators they're looking at. They're very, very aware of how to sift through real and fake. And actually, again, when we look at the research, it's much more likely that someone won't act than they will. Don't forget, we live in a culture very much which is mind your own business, you know, teachers, this is not your responsibility. And I think, if anything, all this does is allows you to kind of be in contact with a professional that helps you make that decision. You know, people aren't, going to act, you know, right away. The NSPCC will decide, is this a police issue? Is this probably an issue that doesn't, you know, mean something? Is this a social services issue? Or is this a wait and see what happens issue? So it's actually having someone that deals with this 24 hours a day helping you decide. Mm.
I wonder how much information is needed in a text, because I suppose part of the problem might be that you get lots of sort of little short texts which might alert you to something really frightening that's going on, but there just isn't enough information in it.
Precisely. So I think what happens is you send a text, I think it's something like 432 characters, then you immediately get one back saying someone will contact you. They contact you within 3 hours by text, and they say to you, look, if you're happy to speak, here's the number, but if not, more than happy to continue by text. Again, it's about facilitating communication that feels comfortable for the person giving it, and oftentimes it feels like should I be the right person doing this? So depending on your own kind of beliefs around this, it'll be easier or more difficult. So is there scope for calling? Absolutely. But I think it's just the first way to kind of wade in.
A text is not anonymous, though, is it? I mean, it's traceable.
Well, in this case, it's turned into an email, which is anonymous, so they won't see your name. And unless there is serious reason to believe, you know, something extreme is happening, it won't be traced. Mm.
Okay, but in theory, that could happen. I mean, you could be traced back to the original text you sent.
Yeah, but only to save a child's life, presumably, and only if in extreme cases. So in the vast majority of cases, like I said, it's converted and this all data protection acts are in place in order to kind of, you know, protect the person texting.
Do you think the major problem with child protection in this country currently is that neighbours, friends are not reporting it? Or do you think...
Do you know what? I do. I mean, it's funny. I was speaking with my husband the other day, and he's Greek, and he's kind of, I think, kind of just grown up in a sort of a smaller place in Cyprus. And we were driving, and the mother was really screaming at her child, like, and shaking it. And he immediately stopped the car. I'm like, what are you doing? And he just said, put the window down. He said, are you okay? What's going on? And you could just see how immediately she sort of set back and stopped. And I thought, you know, I wonder how many of us would have, I think I would have continued, frankly.
But that's different
driving.
From texting the NSPCC to say you're concerned about it, because that might take it to an entirely different level, mightn't it?
Well, it might, but I think, again, I don't think, you know, people, as we've seen a lot with social workers, nobody wants to remove their children from, you know, from their parents' homes, but we do still want to protect them. And there have been many, many cases where people could act, but they didn't afford this fear. And I think we have to, I think it's just about weighing up pros and cons. The vast majority of us are rational enough to kind of, you know, decide that. I think these fears that, oh my God, you know, we're going to do something awful. I think if a child is, you know, that's around you is clearly being neglected, you know, you can see it is clearly being abused, then sending an anonymous text, you know, is a very easy and a very kind of simple way to kind of do something that's potentially positive for that child.
And that system in place now?
It's in place. 8858, it's in place now.
All right.
Yeah, we can just repeat that for you. The text to the NSPCC on 8858. Thank you very much.
Linda, thank you very much. It's 8:15, still to come on breakfast. But now here's... Now, does your job leave you worried? The mental health charity Mind says work is the most stressful part of many people's lives and it beats other health problems or money concerns. 8:27, coming up, BBC...
But here on breakfast...